how Russia's $500 FPV drones destroying $10 million tanks in Ukraine. Hey everyone, welcome back to Taipur Update. In the ongoing war between Russia and Ukraine, many advanced weapons have been used, but did you know that a battle tank worth millions of dollars, covered in thick armor, equipped with advanced weaponry, and built to dominate the battlefield? Now that tank is being torn to pieces by a $500 drone. Welcome to modern warfare in Ukraine, where FPV drones, once used just for racing and hobbies, have become lethal weapons of war. Cheap, small, hard to spot, but deadly accurate. So, how are they doing it? Why are traditional tank defenses failing? And what does this mean for the future of war? This is the story of cheap drones versus expensive tanks, the tactical revolution changing everything. FPV drones, short for first-person view, started off as a hobby. They carry a small camera, stream real-time footage to the pilot wearing goggles, and are mostly used for racing or filming. But war changes everything. Today, those same drones are being modified with explosives, remote control systems, and custom flight paths. They cost just a few $100s, yet can destroy trucks, bunkers, and even tanks. Small, nimble, and hard to detect, FPV drones can sneak through tight spaces, dive straight onto a target, and detonate at the weakest points. They're not high-tech military marvels, they're garage-built game-changers. Main battle tanks like the Abrams, Leopard, Challenger, or T-90 look unstoppable. Thick armor, massive guns, and layers of high-tech defense systems. But every tank has weak spots. The top of the turret is thinner. The rear, where the engine sits, is more vulnerable. That's exactly where FPV drones strike. They come in from above or behind, hitting areas the armor isn't built to protect. Even a drone exploding near the tank's tracks can disable it, immobilizing a $10 million machine in seconds. The result? A battlefield full of burnt-out steel, taken out by backyard-built drones. FPV attacks aren't just random, they're coordinated. It usually starts with a recon drone spotting targets from the sky. Once identified, a trained FPV pilot gets in position, locks on, and launches the attack. Some attacks happen in waves. One drone disables movement, another hits the turret, a third finishes the job. All of this happens from a safe distance, often miles away. Pilots sit in bunkers, watching screens, flying drones like they're in a video game. But this is no game. It's remote warfare at its deadliest. You might think, don't tanks have anti-drone systems? Some do. They're designed to detect missiles or RPGs and fire countermeasures. But FPV drones are a different beast. They're tiny, fly super low, and move erratically. Most radar systems just don't see them. Even when detected, response time is often too slow. These drones can zigzag, dive, and switch directions in a heartbeat. What about signal jamming? It's hit or miss. Many drones are pre-programmed with GPS or visual targeting, so even if the signal's lost, they still hit their mark. Bottom line? Most defense systems weren't built for threats this small, fast, and unpredictable. War isn't just about strategy, it's about economics. And this is where FPV drones shine. A modern tank can cost $10 to $15 million. Add in fuel, crew training, and maintenance, it's a massive investment. Compare that to a $500 FPV drone. For $100,000, you could launch 200 of them. If just 10% of those hit a major target, the damage far outweighs the cost. This is asymmetric warfare taken to the next level, where a dirt-cheap drone can neutralize a multi-million dollar asset. One reason this tactic works so well is mass production. FPV drones aren't just built by militaries. Civilians, hackers, and volunteers are building them by the thousands. From 3D printers to open-source flight software, everything needed is cheap and available. There are even training programs now, teaching drone pilots to fly, target, and strike with insane accuracy. The result? These aren't just hobbyists anymore. They're full-blown drone units, trained and ready, operating just like artillery or sniper teams. What started as DIY warfare is now military doctrine. Does this mean the age of tanks is over? Not quite. But it does mean tanks need support, more than ever. They can't roll out alone. They need air cover, infantry, and drone escorts. Militaries worldwide are watching and adapting, investing in counter-drone tech, AI-powered radar, and their own drone strike units. The battlefield is evolving. Victory now depends not just on strength, but speed, flexibility, and innovation. In the past, wars were won by the biggest guns and the thickest armor. But that's changing fast. Today, a $500 drone flown by a teenager can take out a tank. It's no longer about who has the biggest weapons, but who can adapt the fastest, using small, smart tools to outmaneuver the giants. Welcome to the future of warfare.